गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग माय प्रेजेंटेशन आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक डॉक्टर प्रशांत सर फॉर इनिशिएटिंग सच अ ब्यूटीफुल कंसेप्ट ऑफ ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन। थैंक यू सर। माय प्रेजेंटेशन इज ऑन पपाया ब्रीडिंग। इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन आई विल डिस्कस दीज टॉपिक्स: सेंटर ऑफ डाइवर्सिटी, जर्मप्लाज्म रिसोर्सेज, इम्पॉर्टेंट वाइल्ड रिलेटिव्स ऑफ पपाया, ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, बोटनी, फ्लोरल बायोलॉजी एंड पॉलिनेशन, एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट सेक्स फॉर्म्स। देन ब्रीडिंग मेथड्स एंड अचीवमेंट्स इन ब्रीडिंग एंड सेलेक्शन, इंडक्शन ऑफ पॉलीप्लॉयडी, हाइब्रिडाइजेशन, म्यूटेशन ब्रीडिंग, बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, एम्ब्रायो कल्चर, ट्रांसजेनिक पपाया, फ्यूचर थर्स्ट, एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन आंसर्स। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द इंट्रोडक्शन। इट्स बोटैनिकल नेम इज कैरिका पपाया। देन द फैमिली इज कैरिकेसी। क्रोमोसोम नंबर इज 18। पपाया इज एन आइडियल फ्रूट क्रॉप फॉर ग्रोइंग इन किचन गार्डन्स, बैकयार्ड ऑफ आर होम्स, एज वेल एज ऑर्चर्ड, स्पेशली दोज प्लेसिस nearer to cities or big town. It is also grown as a filler plant in orchards. Pepain is prepared from the latex of immature fruits. It is a proteolytic enzyme used for tenderizing the meat as well as used in leather for tanning and cosmetics. The ripe fresh fruit is a rich source of vitamin A, vitamin C, carbohydrates and minerals. As all of you know that the fruits which are yellow in color, these are the rich source of vitamin A. It is also known as wholesome fruit, which is valued for its nutritional and medicinal properties. Economically, the productive lifespan of papaya is 3 years, and every time a new plantation has to be raised. So our next heading is Center of Diversity. Papaya is native to tropical America. The South America and Costa Rica are the microcenter of origin of papaya. It is a close relative of Carica peltata. In India, it was introduced in the early part of the 16th century from Philippines through Malaysia. India is the largest producer of papaya in the world. In India, it is widely cultivated in UP, Bihar, Karnataka, Jharkhand and MP. So, our next heading is germplasm resources. The family Caricaceae consists of 6 genera and 35 species. Carica and Voskonella are the important genera. The genus Carica has only one species, Carica papaya, the cultivated one. Voskonella contain 21 species, which are considered as the wild relatives of papaya. Presently, germplasm is maintained at TNAU, Bangalore, IARI, Pusa Bihar, Ranchi, Bhubaneswar, Lucknow for further characterization and evaluation. Next one is important wild relatives of papaya. Some Voskonella species are used in interspecific hybridization for resistance breeding. Voskonella cauliflora, which is resistant to the virus. It is most often asked in the exam that which Voskonella species is resistant to virus. So the answer is Voskonella cauliflora. Voskonella cantamarsensis, Voskonella pentagona are resistant to frost. These are also the important ones. Based on the crossability and compatibility, it has been observed that Voskonella monaica, Voskonella cauliflora, Voskonella cantamarsensis are easily crossable with each other and producing the viable seeds. The species Voskonella cauliflora, Voskonella pubescens, Voskonella stipulata, Voskonella candidens are resistant to the papaya ring spot virus. But intergeneric hybridization of these species with the Carica papaya did not produce mature seeds. However, by using the embryo culture technique, immature embryo can be developed into the mature embryo. So our next heading is regional and national varieties. First of all, in all the varieties of papaya, it is very important to memorize that which is dioecious or which is gynodioecious cultivar, and it is oftenly asked in the exam. So let us start with the Pusa Majesty variety. It is a gynodioecious cultivar developed by the seed mating of Ranchi variety. Fruit is moderately sweet. TSS is 7 to 10 degree Brix. Next is Pusa Giant. It is a dioecious selection developed by the seed mating and selection from Ranchi. It yields about 40 kg per tree. Next variety is Pusa Delicious. Pusa Delicious is a gynodioecious selection from Ranchi and it is used for the table purpose. Next one is Pusa Dwarf. It is also developed by selection and seed mating from the Ranchi variety. The most important point of Pusa Dwarf variety that it is used for the high density planting. So the next cultivar is Korg Honeydew. It is a gynodioecious selection from Honeydew, cultivated for both table as well as for the processing. Pink Flash Sweet. It is a gynodioecious selection, higher yield with pink pulp. Arka Surya. It is also an advanced generation hybrid of Sunrise Solo and Pink Flash Sweet. Next cultivar is Arka Prabhat. It is also an advanced generation gynodioecious hybrid from the cross of Arka Surya, Taichung 1 and Local Dwarf. The plants are semi-vigorous. Punjab Sweet. It is released by the PAU Ludhiana. The cultivar was developed by seed mating lines obtained from Kenya. It is a dioecious cultivar. Next heading is the international varieties. The country Australia have varieties Improved Peterson, Guinea Gold. Let us talk about Improved Peterson. It is dioecious type, yellow in color. Guinea Gold, it is hermaphrodite variety. It is also yellow in color. And the varieties from USA, Florida are Betty. It is dioecious and yellow in color. Homestead, dioecious, and it is also yellow in color. Then from USA, Hawaii, Sunrise, it is hermaphrodite and red in color. Now, what are the objectives of papaya breeding? To develop dwarf, statured, and early bearing varieties. To evolve varieties with high yield and good quality fruits. To develop varieties with low cavity index and more pulp thickness. To breed varieties having good keeping quality and suitable for expert purpose. Breeding for high latex yield with high proteolytic enzyme activity. To develop varieties resistance to the biotic and abiotic stress, virus, frost, water logging, etc. Let's go to our next heading, which is how to identify male and female flowers in papaya. First of all, let us see how to identify male flower. The male papaya tree has no fruit, just a big cluster of flowers on long stalks. Male papaya produce many flowers on long stalks. You can identify male flower by their shape, color and location. Male flowers will look like elongated bells on trumpets. Each male flower will have 10 filaments supporting anthers. These look like long threads and topped with fuzzy anthers. So, next one is how to identify the female flowers. They are large in size but short. The ovary should be visible at the base of the flower, giving the flower a stocky appearance. The stamens are very apparent in the middle of the flower, but there are no filaments or anthers. The flower is rounder in shape. See the photo. The flower is rounder in shape, puffed out by the fat ovary inside. The flower has an ovary with the branching lemon yellow stigma. The stigma is the portion where the pollen from a male or hermaphrodite flower lands, but no bright orange male anthers. The fruit can have many shapes depending on variety, from rounded to globose. Next one is botany. It is a dioecious plant, but gynodioecious cultivars are also available. The stem is hollow and soft wooded. It is usually unbranched when young, but at later stage, upright shoots develop at its terminal growth due to obstruction. The flowers are cymose, fragrant, borne in leaf axils. The fruit is fleshy berry. The fruits from pistillate flowers are ovoid oblong to nearly spherical in shape, and the fruits from hermaphrodite flowers are pyriform, cylindrical or grooved. Floral biology and pollination. Dioecious papaya produces male and female trees separately on different plants in the ratio of 1:1, while gynodioecious cultivar produces both female and andromonoecious trees in the ratio of 1:2. These ratios 1:1 and 1:2 are very important. Female and male flowers develop within 32 and 42 days respectively after bud initiation. The period from bud initiation to anthesis is shorter for male than female flower bud. Stamen development occurred prior to the ovary development in the hermaphrodite flower, and stamen differentiation was observed 56 to 59 days before anthesis. Anther dehiscence start 18 to 36 hours before the flower's opening and continuous depending upon the weather conditions, and stigma becomes receptive a day before the flower opening and remaining receptive for 6 days. The peak anthesis was observed between 5 and 6 a.m. The receptivity of stigma was found maximum on the day of anthesis in most of the species. Next heading is sex forms. There are basically two major sex forms in papaya. One is dioecious and another one is gynodioecious. In dioecious, male and female trees segregate in the ratio of 1:0. Seed mating is done for maintenance of the purity. In gynodioecious, female and andromonoecious trees segregate in the ratio of 1:2. Selfing of bisexual flowers is done for obtaining the pure seeds. From here, now I will discuss the breeding methods and achievement. Let us start with the inbreeding and selection. In dioecious lines, suitable male plants are selected from the same progeny which resemblance to the female plants in vegetative characters such as stem, leaf color, stem thickness, height at flowering, etc. Progenies raised from S1 inbreds are screened, and desired male and female plants are selected for further seed mating. Crossing between the female plant and the male plant of the same cultivar. This process is continued for 7 to 8 generations. Why we are repeating this process? To achieve uniformity for a group of characters. In this method, the progeny will have male and female in equal proportion. Many dioecious cultivars have been bred by this method. Now, I will discuss the important cultivars of papaya which are developed through selection. The first cultivar is CO1. It is dwarf, fruit is round, selected from cultivar Ranchi. Next is CO2 cultivar. It is a pure line selection from local type. It is suitable for pepin production in terms of high enzymatic activity. Actually, it is a dual purpose variety, both for desert fruit as well as for processing of pepin. CO3 cultivar, it is a hybrid between CO2 and Sunrise Solo. Plant is vigorous, fruit is medium in size with good keeping quality. So next is CO4 cultivar. It is a hybrid between CO1 and Washington CO5 cultivar. It is a selection for Washington. It is also good for pepper production in terms of high latex yield. It is most often asked in the exam which cultivar has the highest pepper production. The answer is CO5. Next is CO6. It is a selection from giant Korg honeydew. It is a gynodioecious selection from honeydew Pusa majesti. It is a selection from Ranchi cultivar and it is a gynodioecious variety suitable for high pepper production. Next heading is induction of polyploidy. Hofmeyer was the scientist who reported polyploidy in papaya. They found that the quality of tetraploid fruit was better than the diploid and it was also compact with small seed cavity. But tetraploids were less fertile than diploid as indicated by the comparative seed count. However, according to Singh, there was complete sterility in both female and male tetraploids and expressed doubt about their commercial utilization. Further, Jarpa reported that colchicine induced tetraploid hermaphrodite plants which were used as male parent in a cross with a female diploid produced a few seeds without endosperm. By embryo culture, two triploid plants were obtained which turned out to be hermaphrodite. Next heading is hybridization. A few hybrid varieties have been developed by the intervarietal or intergeneric hybridization, but still there is a great scope for development of superior cultivars with better quality and yield. At TNAU Coimbatore, three varieties have been developed: CO3, CO4, CO7. At IIHR Bangalore, two hybrids, IIHR 39, named as Surya, which is a cross of Sunrise Solo and Pink Fresh Sweet, and IIHR 54 were developed. Hybrid HPSC3, which is a cross of Tripura Local and Honeydew, was developed by the ICR Research Complex Tripura. Cultivar Polyflora was developed by crossing K2 and K3 lines of papaya, which is tolerant to the papaya ring spot virus. Mutation breeding. Ram and Majumdar in 1981 developed a dwarf mutant line by treating papaya seed with 15K gamma rays. Initially, three dwarf plants were isolated from M2 population. Repeated SIB mating among the dwarf plants helped in stabilizing a homozygous dwarf line which is known as Pusa nana cultivar. In vitro propagation and genetic engineering technique can serve as a potential tool to overcome major constraints in papaya breeding. Nowadays, the scientists are more focusing on biotechnology. Embryo culture. In papaya, incompatibility is mainly due to the failure of endosperm formation. The hybrid embryo resulting from interspecific cross of Carica papaya and Carica cauliflora has been successfully rescued on White's medium in 30 days by Young. Transgenic papaya. Transgenic papaya has been developed against papaya ring spot virus because in papaya the main disease which is caused by the virus is PRSV. Using coat protein mediated resistance in University of Hawaii by Dennis Gonsalves. The coat protein gene from PRSV was isolated, cloned and used for transforming papaya to provide resistance against the severe strain of the same virus. The target cultivars used in transforming papaya were the red-fleshed Sunset Solo and the yellow-fleshed Kofo Solo. Transformation with coat protein gene was done using microprojectile bombardment technique using embryogenic tissue of papaya. Future thrust in variety improvement. Papaya, although has varied uses, it is underexploited. However, of late, papaya growing for processing and pepper production has become a profitable proposition in India. Looking back at the progress made, the future needs of varietal improvement in papaya are exploration, conservation, and characterization of genetic variability. Second one is development of stable gyno-dioecious genotypes for pepper production. The third one is production of genetically pure seeds by controlled pollination. The fourth one is development of dwarf gyno-dioecious lines. And the last one is breeding varieties resistance to biotic and abiotic stress. Now it's time for question answers. The first question is, papaya is known as wholesome fruit. Yes, it is true. Papaya is a fleshy berry type of fruit. Yes, it is true. Name a transgenic papaya. You can say rainbow variety. Name two papaya varieties suitable for pepper extraction as well as table purpose, CO2 and CO5. All these questions I have also discussed with you when I was dictating my presentation. Voskanella cauliflora is resistant to papaya ring spot virus. Yes, it is true. Pusa nana is developed through mutation breeding. Yes, it is true. Two major sex forms in papaya are dioecious and gyno-dioecious. Now, it's time for match the following. Try to solve the questions. I will discuss the answers later. So, here goes the answers. Dioecious, you can match with CO5. Gyno-dioecious with CO7. IARI variety, Pusa Majesty. Pusa Giant, it is tolerant to strong wind. HPSC3, it is resistant to the papaya mosaic. Now, at last, during lockdown, I want to thank all those people who worked day and night, and especially our teachers who worked hard to provide proper study material to their students as far as possible during the difficult lockdown period. And I also want to give special thanks to Dr. Prashant Bakshi sir, who always active on social media to explore us with new online platform, whether it is regarding of new apps like Anchor, Spotify, Zoom apps, or regarding giving important questions, presentations of important questions which can be asked in our JRF or SRF exams. Sir, actually all these things have now possible only because of you. So I want to specially thank you for all these things you have done for us. Thank you, sir.